rejoice and come in. Enter, rejoice and come in. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice and come in.
Eucharistic celebration, we join Mary Bahemuka and family who pray for the souls of Gaetano Bahemuka, Hilary Bahemuka, and Bonita Tukahirwa. May the Lord grant them eternal rest. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God the Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, today Jesus Christ reminds us that he is the vine and we are the branches. To be able to bear fruit in life, we have to remain attached to him always. But oftentimes we attach ourselves to things that are not productive, that lead us away from him. So dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, restorer and lover of innocence, direct the hearts of your servants towards yourself, that those you have set free from the darkness of unbelief may never stray from the light of your truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, some men came down from Judea and were teaching to the brethren, "Unless you are circumcised according to the custom of Moses, you cannot be saved." And when Paul and Barnabas had no small decision and debate with them, Paul and Barnabas and some of the others were appointed to go up to Jerusalem to the apostles and the elders about this question. So, being sent on their way by the church, they passed through both Phoenicia and Samaria, reporting the conversion of the Gentiles, and they gave great joy to all the brethren. When they came to Jerusalem, they were welcomed by the church and the apostles and the elders, and they declared all that God had done with them. But some believers who belonged to the party of the Pharisees rose up and said, "Is it necessary to circumcise them and to change them to keep the law of Moses?" The apostles and the elders were gathered together to consider this matter. The word of the Lord. The response. Let us go. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. I rejoiced when I heard them say, "Let us go to the house of the Lord." And now our feet are standing within your gates of Jerusalem. Jerusalem is built as a city, bonded as one together. It is there that the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord. For Israel will witness it to praise the name of the Lord. They were sent to the throne for judgment, the thrones of the house of David. "Abide in me, and I in you," says the Lord. "He who abides in me bears much fruit."
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O
Lord. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch of mine that bears no fruit, he cuts away, and every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes, that it may bear more fruit. When you are ready, you are already made clean by the word which I have spoken to you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him, he it is that bears much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing. If a man does not abide in me, he is cast forth as a branch and withers, and the branches are gathered, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask whatever you will, and it will be done for you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit and so prove to be my disciples. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
God is good, and all the time. We give thanks to the Lord for the gift of this new day that he has granted us, and for the gift of his word that gives us the energy and the stimulus to start this day. Today, once again, the gospel presents to us a very beautiful mode of relationship that exists between God, Jesus, and us, his followers. God is the vine dresser, and Jesus is the vine, and we are the branches belonging to this vine, which belongs to God the Father. Meaning, therefore, that through Jesus Christ, the true vine, the love of God and his life flows also to us, who are the branches attached to him. And this love and life flow only to those who are in a way attached through a relationship to Jesus Christ, because without this attachment, we wither and die. We need Christ in order to stay alive and produce fruit. Also, in this allegory, we have heard that the Father reveals himself as one who is so caring towards his vineyard. He has concern for it and pays attention so that it does what it is supposed to do, and that is bearing abundance of fruit. But this care and concern, as we have heard in the gospel, is shown in two action verbs that he does to the vineyard. And the very first one is cutting away, and the second one is pruning. These two actions may seem similar, but they are not, because one is done in order to eliminate those parts that are unproductive, that are useless, that are consuming the nutrients for nothing, and yet they are not yielding fruit. Instead, the second one, which is pruning, is an action that is positive. He removes those parts that have already given fruit and then cuts them off so that they can even blossom more and yield more fruit. I think those who are farmers understand the impact of pruning to most of the plants. The more they are pruned, the more they blossom, and the more they also give yield. So God desires also these two actions in us. Sometimes we waste things, we waste time and energy doing things that are not leading us to any productivity at all. Those are the actions that God calls us to cut off. He cuts them away, and instead encourages those that give more, that make us to yield more fruit, or that boost our yields, our productivity. But all this happens only if we abide in Christ and let him abide in us. The fruits or the good things that we desire in life are because of our abiding in Christ. They can only happen if we remain attached to Christ and let that love and life of God open itself to us all. As we have heard also in the first reading, Paul taking an argument among the community because they are talking about being saved. Are those who are not circumcised, can they also be saved? And we see that relationship now, because of Jesus Christ, salvation is open to all. It's not anymore limited to one race. Just as this attachment, Christ calls the entire humanity to be attached to him so as to attain eternal life, so as to attain salvation. So it is not anymore a question of who we are or what we have been, but it's all a pure grace that he invites us to accept each and every day. So let us pray, dear brothers and sisters, that through his word, God may prune us and help us always to remain in him so that we bear abundant fruit. The Lord be with you. Pray, dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. In glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim: Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Paul Semogerere our Apostolic Administrator, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, especially those we remember in this Eucharistic celebration, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. I am the vine, and you are the branches. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who say to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the risen Christ be with you always. And with Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word, and my soul. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Oh.
Has risen and shown his light upon us, whom he has redeemed by his blood. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Let us go forth to love and serve the Lord. A blessed day to you all.